Pinewood nematode is a tiny, tiny worm that attacks pine trees. Basically, they multiply and multiply and just basically block up the tubes that carry the water and nutrients up and down the tree. And so the tree just wilts and then dies. These nematodes originated in the United States, in fact, where it's not really a problem. The trees are rather resistant. It then went to Southeast Asia. And then, as I say, in 1999, it appeared in Portugal, probably imported with wooden packing cases or something like that. And in Portugal, it devastated 500,000 hectares of forest. And despite spending, I think, 38 million euros or something, they really couldn't contain it. We showed that this pheromone is very attractive to the beetle. And in fact, we've increased its attractiveness by combining it with other chemicals that we knew about from other beetles and from the pine trees themselves. So we had a chemical blend which was highly attractive to the beetles which carry the pine wood nematode. With our expertise here at NRI, we were able to actually collect this pheromone, to identify it, its chemical structure. I mean, there have been three, I think, isolated outbreaks in Spain, but using our traps and the other techniques, these have been contained and eradicated. And so the beetle, the nematode, hasn't spread through the forests of Spain and into the rest of Europe. NRI was awarded the Queen's Anniversary Prize for innovation in 2019 for a program of smart control of pests and diseases, and this was one of the components that was put forward, which is a major issue these days, the movement of pests and diseases around the world with huge increases in world trade. Changes in the climate, which means that insects can survive in new habitats. I mean, in the UK, it was unlikely that the beetle and the nematode would survive if it did come into the country, but with a small degree rise in temperature, it potentially becomes a possibility, and the forest research are using our traps to check that the beetle and the disease are not coming into the UK. But I think these days forests are of enormous value. They have a commercial value for wood, paper, resin, wood products and things like that, but I think in addition to that, obviously they have value for recreational purposes. They have value as habitats for wildlife and flora and fauna, and of course these days they are enormous carbon sinks that we really do depend on to help mitigate the effects of climate or reduce climate change.